Hello, my name is Meagan Longoria, and I'm a consultant with Denny Cherry & Associates Consulting, as well as a Microsoft Data Platform MVP, and today I'd like to tell you about five ways you can make your Power BI reports more accessible. So I'm going to take a report that I made and show you how I implement five accessibility tactics. This report is data pulled from Stack Overflow related to questions asked about Power BI. So between January 2015 and mid-March of this year, there were 4,361 questions asked. We can see there were 77% of the questions that were answered, and 38% of questions had the answer accepted by the original poster that asked the question. And very few questions in the Power BI category had their question closed, meaning it was inappropriate or was lacking information. I also can see the number of questions asked over time. The Power BI tag has grown in popularity. We see this by month. And then we can also see tags that were used along with the Power BI tag. So lots of people had DAX questions while they were working in Power BI or something specific to Power BI embedded or report server. But this report is suffering from some accessibility issues. So the first change that I want to make to improve accessibility is alt text. Alt text helps screen readers better read your report. You can find alt text by selecting a visual, going to the formatting pane, going to the general section, and there'll be a box toward the bottom. It's just plain text in there. So I may want to say something like, there were 4,361 questions asked between January 2015 and mid-March 2019. And that's great if this is a static report, because I can include the number in there. And what will happen is the screen reader will read the visual title, the type of chart it is, so card, waffle chart, line chart, and then the alt text. But if we have periodically refreshing data, I may want to use my alt text as a descriptive subtitle. So questions answered is 77%. I may want to describe questions answered as the percent of questions that received an answer. And that way I don't include the number and it doesn't need constant updating. The next thing I'd like to show you is tab order. Tab order helps not only screen reader users, but all keyboard users. You can access tab order through the selection pane. And then you'll have to switch from layer order to tab order. Tab order refers to the order that keyboard users arrive at content on the page. And you can see right now, this is a pretty random tab order that actually has to do probably with the order I put the items on the page. We want it to be the order of intended consumption. So there's three things that I do in tab order. The first is anything that shouldn't be tabbed to, that isn't helpful for a user to land on, should be removed from tab order. So these logos can be removed. All I did was hover and click on that when the no image showed up, and now I cannot tab to those. Then, because lots of visuals have the same name in this list, I can double click to rename them so that it's easier to see what they are. Then once I've renamed all of them, I can take them and drag them to reorder them or use the up and down arrows so that they become the order that I would like a user to analyze these visuals. And once I'm done with that, it'll go from title through the KPI boxes to the waffle charts, the line charts, and then the matrix and the data source note. So that it made a nice kind of Z pattern from the left at the top to the bottom right. Our next accessibility improvement is color contrast for text. There are several issues with color contrast here. The first is that the default font color for titles doesn't contrast enough from a white background. So I can go and see exactly what color that title text is in the formatting pane, and then go to a website at accessible-colors.com. So I can paste my text color in there and my background color is white, and then I can measure it so there's no subjectivity in there and see that my contrast ratio is 1.67. This is not very helpful because I need it to be 4.5. So I can go back to my report and change the font color to something darker. And immediately I can see the difference between this title and the title next to it, and it's easier to read. So this helps people with low vision, but it also helps people with just tired eyes. You've been working all day and you don't want to strain to see what this report says. So once I have that in there, I can use the format painter to do all the other visuals that are similar. Another issue I have is this gray text on a gray background in these cards. So what I'll do is grab the category color from here and paste it into accessible colors, but then I also need this background color. And when we look at background colors, it started with a hex value but added transparency on top of it. So I use a little tool called Instant Eyedropper, and there are lots of these kind of free tools available, some paid, where I can hover over any point on my screen and get the related hex color. And then I can go back to my accessible colors, paste it into the background color. And I got my text color there, and we can see that this contrast ratio is 1.99, which is also not acceptable. So I can go back and change my card colors. The nice thing about this website is it makes a suggestion for you. If you would like to have a greater color contrast ratio, you can either change the background color to their suggested color, or you can change the font color, the foreground, to their suggested color. So I can come in here, go to my category label, paste this right in, and that looks much, much better. And again, I can format paint. Just be sure that you format paint only the boxes where the number formatting is the same. So I may have to select these decimal ones since I didn't do this in the field list, but in the visual itself, come to category. And at this point, it's already in my color list. And be done. And the last color contrast issue is this kind of heat map, the conditional formatting in the matrix. In our conditional formatting, it might be hard to read that blue with black text. So I want to grab the custom color from the highest value, as well as the color from values, the font color, and put those in. And I'll see that my contrast ratio is 2.27, better than the others, but still not good. But instead of taking their suggestion, I might change both the background color and the text color. And by changing each one just a little bit, I stayed within my color palette. I didn't really create a different user experience. It's just easier to read in the darker areas. Our fourth accessibility tip is sort order. If I look at this matrix, it is currently sorted by tag. I've got an alphabetical list. But if I sort it by questions asked and make it descending, I have the most popular tags that were used concurrently with the Power BI tag at the top. So I know there's a bunch of Power BI questions related to DAX or related to Power BI desktop and Power Query, and fewer questions related to Azure Active Directory or reporting services. So this is one visually easier for me because I've now sorted the data so I can get the most popular, but for screen reader users as well, that sort order stays in the accessible show data table, so the screen reader will read DAX first. And my last way to increase accessibility in your report is to get rid of jargon. That's a problem for people who are new to the subject area. That's a problem for people who have trouble just remembering terminology. And we can make reports more accessible by just spelling things out. So for instance, OPs is Stack Overflow or forum lingo for original poster, but I could just make it users asking, and it's easier to understand. And I used some weird terminology in the questions answer accepted, so I can actually change that to questions with accepted answer. One more place that I need to change is this median life days. There's no reason to try to sound scientific by putting my units of measure in parentheses. I can just say in days. And sometimes you just can't get rid of all the jargon, but it's nice to be able to have definitions and helpful information explanations nearby. So I added a tooltip report and a glossary in my data set so that when I hover over something, I can see the definition of it. If you've been wondering what median life in days is, it's just the number of days between question creation and the last activity date, but now you don't have to stop your analysis and forget what you were thinking about to go find that out. The tooltips are nice, but they're not keyboard accessible, so I also have a glossary that I've added. So there's this button up here that goes to a bookmark, and if I control enter on that button, I get the full glossary list that can be read in whole or read by a screen reader using the show data table. I can just tab to my back button, control enter, and I'm good to go. So that was 5 ways to make your Power BI reports more accessible. Thanks for watching.